Shape masks for color correcting is very important when trying to isolate a certain section, and we're about to show you how it works.
We have some footage of a woman being interviewed. The issue is, her skin doesn't have a whole lot of color to it. So we'll saturate her skin, but isolate the saturation adjustment just to her face. Select the clip and position the playhead over it. Then, navigate to the enhancements icon under the viewer and click on the Show Color Inspector, or use the shortcut Command-6. Click on the pop-up menu at the top of the Color Inspector. We'll use the Color Board for this correction. We'll select the Saturation tab and increase the Master Control to elevate the saturation of the entire clip. It looks great, but we really want her face to be the focal point. So we'll isolate the saturation by using a shape mask.
Ha! I laugh in the face of advanced techniques.
Hover over the effect name and select the Apply Effects Mask button, which looks like this. In the menu that appears, choose Add Shape Mask. And we can adjust the shape mask in the viewer using the on-screen controls. To reposition the shape, click and drag in the center. To adjust the shape's width or height, we can drag any of the four handles of the inner circle. Let's shape it to her face. To control the roundness of the shape, drag this gray handle on the inner circle. We're going to want to keep it pretty round. To rotate the shape, drag the rotation handle extending from the center. To control the softness of the shape's edge, drag the outer circle. We'll keep it soft to make our saturation correction look more natural. And to show or hide the mask controls, click the Shape Mask On-Screen Controls button to the right of the shape mask name in the list. Down here, we can work on the color correction inside or outside our mask. So if we want to, we could desaturate the background outside the mask just slightly. And we can also invert the masked and unmasked areas if we click Apply Effect Masks and choose Invert Masks. This makes it so the background is saturated rather than her face. Uncheck it to return to the original mask configuration. And we can check and uncheck this box to hide or show a mask. There are no limits to how many masks you can add, so use as many as you need to get the job done. Here's the final result.
Utilizing shape masks for color correction is an outstanding tool, and we recommend you check it out.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, and click that little bell notification so you get notified when the latest Final Cut Pro tutorial is up for grabs.